Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah. Welcome to our short live feed, inshallah. And I'm hoping, as we wait for some people to join on, that I'll be giving brief introductions to this concept of natural healing and over the coming 7 days, bismillah. الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين الحمد لله وشكر لله وthank الله سبحانه وتعالى for allowing us inshallah to communicate and to share and exchange knowledge with one another. And one of the most important things that Allah سبحانه وتعالى has sent us on this earth for, you know, one particular reason, so that لعلكم تتقون, and that, you know, we become God-fearing, we become aware of what our knowledge is, of who our Lord is, of who our Prophet is, and to live this life in a way that benefits ourselves and benefits the people around us. So it is very important that as we go through life, that we understand what our purpose, what our objective is, and also along the way, we have various challenges. And those challenges will come in the forms of physical illnesses, emotional disturbances, and also through life, you know, that we lose loved ones, and we have family disputes, we have people, you know, because of the differences in our nufus, our nafs, and the desires of wanting to be known, and the desires of, you know, wanting things that are not permissible. And so a lot of these ailments that people, you know, develop over a period of time, they are as a result of emotional imbalances. And again, you know, when we look at it, it's the nafs that is causing these illicit desires to come through. And then we act in a selfish way. We act in a way that harms and hurts other people. So one of the important things that we need to understand is that through life, you know, we have various, you know, departments, so to speak, that, you know, there's a side of us that requires us to be, you know, a father or a husband or a brother. And then there's another that requires you, you know, in your own personal role, to be mentally strong. You know, you're there as a worker, as an employer, as an employee. So whatever it is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the responsibility of, that we need to go through that. Wa alaikum assalam to the people joining us. MashaAllah, jazakallah for joining. And if you have any questions, inshallah, please send them through as well. So through this life, as we're going through life, you know, we end up picking up a lot of ailments. And the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us, now this, inshallah, I think we should just stick with this point today, just to give you a basis of how healing actually works, is that our bodies are made in such a way that in order for them to work effectively, we need energy in our body. We need energy, the free flow of energy in our body, to allow our body to function in the optimal way. So, for example, our body without the ruh, our body without the spirit that's, you know, that's there, is what keeps us alive. And if the spirit is absent from the body, then the body is dead. And the spirit, once it has been placed into the body, that is the time we become alive. In the same way that you take a battery and you stick it into a child's toy. When you stick that battery into the child's toy, all the lights come on, the sounds come on, everything starts to function within it. Now, you have a problem with that toy when a particular, you know, aspect of the toy has been damaged or a wire has been cut, so a particular lights might not work. And in the similar way, subhanAllah, our body functions in a similar way whereby if particular channels or the flows of energy are blocked, then particular parts of our body will begin to experience pain. And so what we need to understand is that in order to fix this, in order to put it right, we need to restore balance in the body. Now, we know we hear from, you know, the Hakims, we hear from the people who specialize in the science of tib, you know, the science of natural medicine, whereby you look at the mizaj, the temperaments of the body. And the temperaments of the body include hot, wet, cold and dry. So there are people, you know, who are very hot in their nature, people who are very cold in their nature, people who are sluggish and phlegmatic in their nature. So all of these different characteristics of a person, you know, needs to be maintained very differently. So you can have two different people, but, you know, the medicine for the two different people will be very, very different based on their temperament type. So this is something that's very important to understand when working with clients, when working with our patients, that what constituent type is this person? Because if this person is not of the right constituent type, and by giving him particular medication, he might actually react and get worse than that. So with natural healing, and especially with Afia healing, what we are trying to achieve is we are trying to achieve balance. We are trying to achieve the free flow of energy. We are trying to identify what is causing the blockage, because a lot of the time it's not a physical issue that's causing the blockage. It's not just a physical trauma, like you fell over or you've hit your knee or hurt your ankle or whatever it may be. It's not that. It's over a period of time that people have been absorbing emotional trauma. So, you know, someone is nasty to you at work, or the amount of work that is, you know, expected of you over a period of time, keeps you in a very highly stressed state. And so, unfortunately, over a period of time, you begin to see that people begin to manifest physical symptoms. Physical symptoms, just like you'd been hurt, just like a muscle has been pulled, just like, you know, you've got kidney stones or something like that, and the pain will be excruciating. And, you know, one thing that's very common, people that suffer with anxiety and stress, is the pain in the chest. You know, the heart really hurts. And subhanAllah, you know, they go to the doctors, they get all these tests done, but ultimately, you know, the final conclusion, well, it's stress-related, nothing physical, so go home and just carry on. But people don't take that as a means to rectify their life on a day-to-day basis. Rather, they just carry on with their stressful life until in the end the heart does show its own signs and say, okay, if you're not listening to the emotional signs, here's a physical sign for you as well. So when we are working using Afia healing, we are looking at understanding what is the root cause of the problem. So if a person comes and they've got a pain in the knee, or they've got a pain in the wrist, in the elbow, wherever it may be, we want to try and identify where exactly the pain is coming from. And the good thing is that with Afia healing, you don't need to be, you know, a medical expert. You don't need to be someone well-versed with, the body and the functionings and the names of the different muscle groups and none of that. All we need you to understand is, as long as you know where the head is, you know where the shoulders are, you know where the back is, the front is, you know where the legs and the thighs are, you know what the ankle is, the knee is, the elbow, alhamdulillah, we can start working. And the simplicity, alhamdulillah, of Afia healing is that it's simply a technique based on breath. So the breath work, as you begin to work with that breath, it begins to generate natural energy, which is already within us. You know, just that we are making you aware of it. So, you know, just like how you have a niggling pain in the back of your head or the back or whatever, and you normally ignore it and it's never there. But once you put your mind to it, it becomes more apparent. It hurts that much more. So similarly, energy is always flowing within us, because it is a direct consequence of the ruh actually being within our body. So because the ruh is in our body, energy naturally flows. But if you become aware of that energy through simple breath work and through simple, you know, mind and body awareness techniques, then alhamdulillah, you can actually feel that energy flowing. And this is why, you know, when sometimes people come and they touch you, or you shake someone's hand, they place their hand on you, you feel this heat that's generated, you know, this heat that's actually there. And subhanAllah, this is it. That's all we are working with. We're not working with anything sinister. We're not working with the dark forces, na'uzubillah. So we're not interested in all that stuff. All we want is that, can you breathe? If you can breathe, then alhamdulillah, you can learn how to do Afia healing. And with that, inshallah, what we also understand is that by placing our hands on a particular part of the body that is hurting, because it is by fitrah, it is a natural thing that whenever you are hurt, the first thing that you do is your hand will actually go and cover that part that is actually aching. It is, again, you see in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all the pious predecessors, that when anyone came to them with regards to any ailments, physical, emotional, whatever, they would always place their hands upon the part either that was hurting, if it was the head, the back, the stomach, or if it was to do with anxiety, stress, whatever it was, then it would be over the heart. So alhamdulillah, the many du'as, you know, and we can see from prophetic examples, not just of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and everyone before that, Isa alayhi salam, healing the lepers, all the rest of it, alhamdulillah, people go in there and it is placing the hand. Once the hand has been placed on, the natural flow of energy from that person will begin to heal that client of yours, or that person that is actually there. And the amazing thing, alhamdulillah, you know, just to clarify, because a lot of people get wound up by this fact that you can't say you are healing. Yes, I know, I'm not saying I'm healing, but what I am saying is that we are the facilitators that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using for healing to actually take place. So in the same way that we go to doctors, you know, the doctor doesn't heal, but the doctor is a means through which you know, the advice is actually shared with us, or you know, a prescription is given, that inshallah will help our healing to, you know, carry on in the way that Allah wanted. And also another point that we need to clarify as well is, like I said, it's hands-on healing, but at the same time, we do not touch ghair mahrams, okay? And it's very important. And this is why an important aspect of afia healing is the concept of distant healing. A very, you know, deep principle with regards to energy healing in all its forms is that energy follows thought. And wherever your mind goes, your energies will also follow. So simply by, you know, thinking about someone or directing the mind to a particular ailment in, for a particular person in a particular part of the in the house, in the country, in another country, in another corner of the world, alhamdulillah, the energy goes there. So just like this morning, alhamdulillah, I was able to touch base with a client in Australia, in Perth. Alhamdulillah, we did some realignment work and mashallah, the body was moving. And, you know, just the shifts were happening in their own. And then again, after that, another client in the States. So alhamdulillah, distance is not a problem. Distance is not the issue. It's wherever your mind goes, you will be able to help people, you know, to be able to heal. So inshallah, the important message for today then, please, is that our bodies require the free flow of energy to sustain and to maintain well-being. And when those channels get blocked due to physical or emotional issues, then we start experiencing pain and discomfort. As an afia healing practitioner, our job is to raise the vibration high enough and then surround that person. And this is the same way that when you are surrounding and when you are surrounded by people who are happy, who are joyful, who are, you know, in all, you know, the good qualities, you yourself begin to feel in that way. And similarly, if you go and, you know, associate with people who've got bad habits and they smell and all the rest of it, you also start to pick up those habits. So in the same way, if a person is radiating good energy, then alhamdulillah, anyone around them also will also absorb that energy. Even if your mind doesn't want to absorb the energy, even if you don't want to believe that this works or not, your body will take it. Your body will say, Jazakallah khair, please give it to me. I need to start healing. So these are things that we need to become aware of. And inshallah, in the coming days and weeks, I hope to share these sorts of gems with you, these little insights. And inshallah, if you do have questions, then please ask the questions. If there are people, you know, wanting to doubt the methodology or, you know, want to give any fatwas or whatever, just ask inshallah. Wa alaikum salam, sisters, inshallah, all hope you're all well, alhamdulillah. So with that, inshallah, just clarify, please, because, you know, this is an open discussion point, alhamdulillah. And join us, inshallah, so that, you know, and ask your questions, whatever questions they are. If it is to do with particular healing, you know, inshallah, Sister Shanaz, inshallah. Tonight, we've got the Afia Healing Bubble, which is going to be at 9:30 your time. So please, inshallah, just join in. And then, inshallah, when the overall healing is done, then, inshallah, you can benefit from that as well. So just touching on that, you know, on a Monday and a Thursday, we have what is known as the Afia Healing, you know, group session. We call it the Afia Healing Bubble, which you can find on Facebook as well. And on there, inshallah, if you just leave your name and your ailment and how bad it is and where you're from, then inshallah, we can actually help and work with you, inshallah. So that, inshallah, is something that is there as a free service. And alhamdulillah, Mondays and Thursdays, all the Afia practitioners that are willing to participate from all corners of the world, alhamdulillah, join us at that time. And then whoever's names are put on there, we all, you know, send our energy and we hope that inshallah, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by his mercy, will be able to deal with that. Wa alaikum salam, Brother Hanif. Hope you're well, mashallah. It's been a long time, but still, inshallah, one day, hopefully we meet. So, alhamdulillah. So, yeah, we've got a few people from Zimbabwe, from South Africa, from the UK, alhamdulillah. So, inshallah, please, and from the US as well. Wa alaikum salam, Sister Maryam. Hope you're well. And inshallah, with that, please, people, ask questions, okay? We want a dialogue and we need to understand what is actually going on. So with that, inshallah, we come to the conclusion and then hopefully tomorrow at the same time, I'll be doing another session just like this, supporting a global event for the healing and recollaboration of the planet, and I will call it 7 days of rest. Okay, inshallah, Sister Rose, we will look into that and I'll get back to you on that, inshallah. Where do you record your name? Okay, inshallah, Sister Naima, if you can search on Facebook for Afia Healing Bubble. Afia Healing Bubble. And I think the tag sign for it is afia.bubble. So inshallah, if we can do that, then that would be brilliant. So yes, inshallah, natural healing modality falls within the principles of Sharia and Sunnah. You know, it doesn't mean that you can, you know, take it exactly as it was in the Sunnah and say, oh, you're not following that. No, it is a technique that every human being can do, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has instilled with every human being. So thereby, you have to allow it. And also, there's, you know, if there's nothing haram about it, don't make something haram that's not haram. So inshallah, yes, we're constantly in touch with the ulama and the mashayikh. And inshallah, if anything sinister was to come up, then inshallah, we would be able to address it very quickly. So inshallah, please do send your questions through. Inshallah, I look forward to holding this session again tomorrow. And this works as long as inshallah you participate and share as well with your friends and loved ones. Jazakumullah khair. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.